Now, please join me in welcoming Marc and Sola.
Thank you, Dean James, for that warm introduction. And thank you, Marc, for having this conversation with me today.
Absolute pleasure.
So I'm a firm believer that our upbringing, the people we interact with, and the experiences that we have growing up greatly impact our thought process and how we navigate through life in general. I'm curious if you have a fond memory or an important lesson you learned growing up that you still reflect on today.
For me, it's the same lesson I pass on to my children. And I say it simply, everyone's coming back. So some people define that as pay it forward without any expectation of something in return. But in our world, it's so interconnected. And especially in an online world, how do people know who you are? It's the people who vouch for you. It's the people you've helped along the way. It's the resumes you've reviewed, the people you've mentored, the calls you've made, the problems you've solved. This is what defines your reputation and the thing that you need to protect. I've never been disappointed by the payback.
I absolutely love that. Everyone's coming back, something that I would definitely be keeping in mind.
In the Wharton universe, everyone is coming back.
Specifically in the Wharton universe, everyone is coming back. So speaking of Wharton, you were both an undergrad and an MBA student. What is an important experience that you believe impacted your career?
I don't know that there's one experience. I'll say that first, my time here was absolutely amazing. I had the best of all worlds. I had a graduate education and an undergraduate social life, which is exactly how you want to experience the University of Pennsylvania in its fullest. But while you're here, you lack perspective. You can't see the studying around the clock, the finals crammed into 1 week, or really know what it is that you know until you get to your first job. When I got to my first job and sat down at the desk, it all just made sense. I was shocked at how much I knew. And I believe you will be shocked by how much you know.
So you spoke a little bit about your career, your first job outside of Wharton. I'm curious if there are any soft skills or technical skills that you believe have contributed to your successful career as a global investor.
I'll speak to me personally. I think first I'll say I think there are a lot of roads or a lot of paths to success, and a lot of people have different strengths that they bring to the table. For me, I was fortunate early to discover that what I loved, I was also good at. And I'm a problem solver, a puzzle solver. Mm-hmm. And I'm also capable of articulating a solution to a complex puzzle, whether it is an organizational design problem, a complex deal mm-hmm. for Apollo, or a complex business situation. It really is what I like to do. And as I look back and think about what has made me successful, it's actually finding something that fits with what you're innately good at. That also is really important to the job you're doing.
So as we go off into the real world, a lot of us as graduating seniors are thinking about investing a portion of our income. What is the number one tip that you would give to us as we think about investing?
You know, I think it's just too soon. I mean, I will say that I do think that there's a progression that you're going to see. And I'll describe my progression. In my 20s, I was really just all about career. First, I was paying back my student debt. And then it was all about career. In my 30s, I finally had enough success, and now it was about building my family. And into my 40s, and at 50, it gets to be really fun because I work only because I want to work and because I love what I'm doing. And you have the chance to actually step back and contribute to others.
A year from now, what do you believe would be the most important thing that you would want to carry forward from the past year, and why?
No, it's not just what I would carry forward. Let's face it, a lot of us would like to just forget the past year. But the reality is that none of us will forget the past year. We'll remember the tragedy, the hardship, the people we've lost. But I think we're really going to remember that we experienced a decade of change in 1 year. And whether it's me as an individual or you as an individual or the institutions around us or the businesses, all of us discovered that we were highly adaptable. And in a Wharton context, think of how much business contributed to the year, whether it was the logistics that adapted overnight, the healthcare system that pivoted to COVID, the technological and broadband infrastructure that kept us all working from home, pharmaceutical and biotech that raced to find a cure. This is an amazing thing. And if I were just coming into the workforce, I would think that all this change is opportunity.
Thank you so much, Mark, for spending time with us and sharing your words of wisdom. It was really a pleasure to be able to talk to you today.
Absolute pleasure. Thank you for interviewing me.